Helga says I spend too much time at my terminal.
She's probably right.
While you've been in the field, we've had more reports about farmers being threatened and attacked. Unfortunately, some didn't survive. It's worse. It's tragic. How's your investigation proceeding? That's assuming he finds something useful. Otherwise, you'll be no better off than when you started.
Let's move on. I asked the other Rangers to share their opinions of you. There are some things I want to go over. We'll start with Ranger Callow in Hopetown. She was grateful for your timely arrival and impressed you had the guts to take on those pirates. Nia says you were respectful with Ron Hope and didn't push too hard. That shows me you were listening when I said to go easy on. Exactly. Dealing with the council can be tough, but it comes with a badge. No need to make it harder than it already is.
Let's continue. We've got a detailed report from Ranger Price about your recent visit to Neon. He said you took on a syndicate loan shark to help an informant. And you were right to do so. Helping people is our most important duty, even when you're conducting an investigation.
You got results, and that's what matters most. Price was impressed by that. Said you really took the initiative.
Ranger McMillan praised what she called your uncommon bravery and dedication. She said you took on the Red Mile so you could get a meeting with Marco Graziani. Putting the lives of others ahead of our own comes with the job. I'm sure it was a tough call, but I think it was the right one.
So what happened with Marco? I doubt he gave you that slate out of the kindness of his heart. I suppose underestimating you was his last mistake. Damn. I thought if anyone could see reason, it'd be Marco. What about Maya Cruz? Her loyalty to Hull and the 1st Cavalry was stronger than most. I guess I'd want the same thing if I were in her place.
Excuse me, Marshal?
Not now, Alex. We're in a meeting here.
I know, but this is important. I've done it. I've cracked the encryption on the slates. Now, I don't know exactly where the 1st are headquartered, but there are references to a place called the Factory.
The Factory? That was our nickname for the main facility where the mechs were manufactured.
Under the terms of the peace treaty, they shut all the mech factories down right after the war.
But they didn't destroy them. At least not all of them. The facility was on Arcturus II. It could be a dead end, but if it's not, then you'd better be ready for a fight.
If the Marshal's right, you could encounter serious resistance. Be prepared.
Good hunting.
Go get him, deputy.
It's really an honor.
Just making my way.
The doctor can provide any supplies you might want.
He used to be an actuary. Yeah.
Thank you. Rav drive spinning down. Systems green. Docking cycle complete.
Isn't the pirate who saved the fleet. It's good business having you here. Whatever you need, as long as you can afford it. Done here? Fine by me.
Yeah.
Now you buckle.
Well, the right protective gear can make all the difference. Well, only the best protective gear you can find.
See ya.
Da, I get it. You're a celebrity. Now, are you going to buy something or what? All right, let's get this over with.
Even try to rip me off. I know value when I see it. We can talk about whatever you want, as long as you got the creds. Don't miss me too much.
Fogged Grog is fine.
Great Authority takes anything and everything.
Give me an
always looking forward to something mutually beneficial. Your credits are always good at the Trade Authority.
I used to work for a megacorp.
With SysDef gone, I'm going to have a lot more time on my hands. Maybe I'll read a book. Well, let's see what we need. Someone's seen better days. Way better. Try not to squirm. You might make it worse. There. You're good to go. Sure. Whatever keeps you off my operating table. Try not to die out there.
If you got any spare creds or just need to unload some junk, head to the depot.
Jump drive is offline. Landing site locked. Take us in.
Thank you. Justice. It's waiting for you inside.
I'm a man of action. I've got no use for lies. So when I tell you that you're being manipulated, you know I'm telling the truth. You think the Council of Governors really cares about anything but themselves? They're greedy and corrupt. You're a tool in the hands of the unworthy, just like I once was. I was loyal. I followed orders, and I led good men and women to their deaths. I'll carry the stain of that dishonor to my grave.
Thank you.
The First Cavalry was the greatest fighting force the Freestar Collective has ever seen. At the Battle of Nera, the First Cavalry was destroyed. Why? Because the generals got scared and asked for a truce. I've got no sympathy for cowards. Or for the people who put them in power. I've also got no sympathy for those who do their bidding.
Hear me!
justice. Well, what about justice for my soldiers? Minutes away, minutes from winning the battle and the war, when the ceasefire order came down. Now there's a debt of honor, and the people of the Free Star Collective are going to pay.
Thank you. believe it? You just took on some of the best mercenaries in the Freestar Collective and cut right through them. If we'd have had more like you in the war, we could have planted our flag in New Atlantis. You fought because you had to, and you fought well. Don't apologize for that. More importantly, you survived. Most soldiers don't. I know, because I'm the one who led them to their death. You don't know what it's like to look around and see the faces of warriors who trusted you to lead them as they die screaming. I watched brave men and women torn limb from limb by monsters. I saw mech pilots cooked alive in their cockpits as their machines burned. Those deaths didn't have to be meaningless, but spineless leaders gave up on us even when victory was within our grasp. You really want to know? Because you might not like the answer. Last chance, deputy. You can walk away right now and remain blissfully ignorant, thinking you fight for a noble cause. But if you still want the truth, I'll shatter that illusion for you right now. We'll see about that. Not long after I started the first, I was contacted by a man who said he represented someone wealthy and influential. I refused to work for a shadow client, so he agreed to set up a meeting. Imagine my surprise when Ron Hope showed up. He offered me a lucrative contract to take possession of certain farms throughout Freestar space. The credits were good, but yeah, getting some payback was the real reward. You think I've lost? Is that it? I haven't lost. You go find Ron Hope and tell him what I've told you. Then you can deal out whatever justice you see fit. You do your job, and I get one last piece of vengeance against the Council. I'm gonna make this easy for you, Deputy. I'm gonna die the way I lived. Weapon in hand, no compromise, no fear. But first, here, take this. Use it to cut out the weakness rotting at the heart of the Freestar Collective. When the next war comes, and it will come, the Collective needs to be strong. Now my unit's waiting for me, and I'm gonna report for duty one last time. Goodbye, Deputy.
thrusters firing. Orbital pattern locked in.